I'm meteorologist Dave Anderson with severe weather update for you. We are looking at a severe thunderstorm watch in effect for many counties in Minnesota till at least 1 o'clock in the morning. And there is, of course, a chance that that could spill into Wisconsin, maybe even the Upper Peninsula, as Friday night into Saturday morning goes on. Storms have been paying off to the west of our region, just outside of our viewing area right now, but very, very close to places like Grand Rapids, and indeed could cross that threshold here as the night goes on. What we're facing right now with this line of storms here from a warm front is high winds that are going 60 to 70 miles per hour, fairly decent sized hail, at least quarter sized hail, and of course lightning. The biggest threats with this system probably will be straight line winds rather than twisting winds like a tornado, but those can cause plenty of damage as well. So folks in Grand Rapids under the gun at this moment, and indeed could spill into the rest of the region here as the night goes on. So keep an eye on CBS3 and CBS3Duluth.com for the latest as the situation goes on. Meteorologist Caitlin Moffitt and I, and perhaps even Austin Haskins, will be burning the midnight oil to keep you abreast of the situation. Here's the forecast then. Minnesota tonight, 90% chance for storms, just in case your town hasn't had them yet. Low temps will be in the 60s, and dew points will be in the 60s as well, so there is fuel for these storms, indeed, from the latent heat of condensation being released. 80% chance that action will be released in Wisconsin as well, with low temps there mid to upper 60s. And then for tomorrow, if tonight's storms are driven by the warm front, tomorrow afternoon and evening, another round of severe weather could be driven by the cold front of this low pressure system. It's a 50-50 shot for that in Wisconsin tomorrow, with high temps getting pretty warm, 85 to 90 degrees. And in Minnesota, it's a 60% chance for the late afternoon, early evening severe weather to return, with inland highs in the mid to upper 80s and slightly cooler by the lake in the 70s. Well, all right, if a cold front is coming in on Saturday to stir up that second round of precipitation for our area and severe weather, well, of course, the cold front will take temperatures down on Sunday. Higher pressure coming in with the cooler air will clear up the sky, and the worst of this weather should be over by then. We just have to grin and bear it and be careful until Sunday comes across.